Joshua R. Sonett, S-O-N-E-T-T-M, chief of the section of thoracic surgery at Columbia University New York Presbyterian Hospital. Lung cancer is a type of cancer that actually begins in the lung. It grows out of the lung cells that, if left alone, can really hurt the patient. Lung cancer predominantly has been caused by smoking in the past. Lung cancer symptoms can be varied. Many times, and initially, it's asymptomatic. In other words, the lung cancer is growing there and not causing any symptoms, and we have to pick it up by screening tests and other parameters. However, coughing up blood, weight loss are probably the biggest symptoms. And sometimes people can present with pain in their shoulder or pain in their arm as a very early symptom of a lung cancer. Somebody suspects they have lung cancer, the first thing they do is they need to go to their doctor and talk about it and see if their symptoms at all warrant further workup. The first initial workup of somebody they're worried about could have lung cancer really starts with a chest x-ray and a chest CT. But first, you need to see your doctor. And the number one cause of lung cancer throughout the United States is the same throughout the world, and it's smoking. Smoking causes 75 to 85% of all the lung cancers in the world. However, we now know that many people can have lung cancer that never smoked and were not even exposed to passive smoke. As much as 15 to 20% of women, in fact, who have lung cancer never smoked. And this is really probably caused mostly by genetic abnormalities. However, there are some other environmental issues that can cause lung cancer, such as radon in basements. Genetics, we are learning, are immensely important in lung cancer. In fact, genetics are immensely important for any disease that anybody has now. But there are clearly people that will develop lung cancer all because of the genetics of their cells, even though they never smoked or were never around radon. Conversely, there are actually some patients who are big smokers and because of their genes will be protected from lung cancer. So the genetic makeup of somebody's cells are extremely important, not only for the development of lung cancer, but now we're learning for the actual treatment of lung cancer. There are many different types of lung cancer. And the first thing that we think about are two types. There are what's called small cell and non-small cell lung cancer. That breakup is really quite significant because most patients with what's called small cell cancer are treated only with chemotherapy or chemo and radiation, while those with non-small cell generally have a somewhat better prognosis and are treated with surgery along with possible chemo and radiation. There are different types of lung cancer within the breakup of non-small cell. Predominantly, they're called adenocarcinoma and squamous cell carcinoma. Staging is extremely important for any lung cancer. We really begin the treatment of any lung cancer or any cancer whatsoever by staging it specifically. And what we're looking at is how early a stage, is it only confined to the lung and nowhere else? Or is it a later stage and has it spread out? The staging of almost all cancers and for lung cancer start with stage 1, 2, 3, and 4. And without getting into the real specifics, really what it means is stage 1 is usually very small and confined to a part of the lung that we can take out with surgery alone, and those patients will be cured 85 to 90% of the time with surgery alone. As it gets bigger and spreads either in size or to lymph nodes or to other organs, and those are the three major parameters of how you stage a tumor. Again, the size of the tumor, whether it's spread to lymph nodes, and whether it's spread outside of the lung to places such as the bone, or liver, or brain. If the tumor has gone to lymph nodes, then it's still extremely curable, but usually then we use chemo and radiation and then surgery to cure it. If the tumor has gone outside the lung to the bone, or the liver, or the adrenals, most of the time for those patients, the treatment is chemotherapy alone or chemo and radiation, and surgery plays less of a role. the major tests to treat lung cancer are really now a screening CAT scan, a CAT scan to tell if there's a lump or mass in the chest. After that CAT scan shows that there's some abnormality in the chest, we usually perform what's called a PET scan, which is a scan that basically cancer cells take up sugar or glucose, and if a tumor or a mass in the lung is alive, it will eat the sugar and it'll light up on the scan. So a PET scan will show if something is actually physiologically active or growing like a cancer. Once you know that you have a mass in the lung that's growing, then the decision will be between you and your doctor whether to take it out directly or to obtain a biopsy of the mass. There are many treatment options, and the treatment options are frankly growing every day for patients with lung cancer. But as we discussed, the treatment options for lung cancer really depend on the stage of the cancer and also the patient themselves. So most patients with very early lung cancer can now have the lung cancer removed using video surgery. 3 or 4 small little holes, which sometimes can be in the hospital only 24 to 48 hours, and have that cancer totally removed for cure. While other patients need much more combined therapy with chemo, radiation, and surgery. Finally, some patients with the advent of personalized medicine can get specialized medicines directed at the genetic makeup of their lung cancer and don't need surgery at all.